EM DJ Tuesday on Sirius XM.
You believe that you are special.
Yes, Car Radio.
Well, somehow the rules do not apply to you.
Channel 90.
Girl, you don't want, I want to move it. And if you want me, girl, you got me. There's nothing I know I wouldn't do. I wouldn't do. Just to get up next to you.
Girl, 11 minutes before the top of the hour, we're back on the morning drive. Thing we've not mentioned, you know, Ryan Blaney went in the Coca-Cola 600. How about that old school vending machine that he gets? Man, I love to have that in my house.
Pretty nice.
As a Coca-Cola drinker, obviously.
Yeah, that would look nice on here in the old Paizan Palace home theater. Yeah, I like that.
I wonder if you plug it in and she works. I mean, I would assume so. I mean, that's a vintage vending machine right there.
We had friends that had a vending machine in of sodas in their basement. They were like big Green Bay Packer fans and had a big Packer logo on it and stuff. And I would just go there and press the button and then it would spit it out. And then sometimes I wouldn't even drink the soda. I just open it back up and put it back in. Just knowing that I could do that though was cool enough for me.
Mm-hmm. When you drank one of those during a big game though, did you choke on it like the Packers do?
No, because this was actually when the Packers were like pretty darn good. This was back when they won a couple Super Bowls and whatnot.
Had to get the dig.
Hey, chunks of that cheese.
I'm sorry, what'd you say, Mike?
Hey, Pete.
Yes.
What is today?
Today, Bagman, is Tuesday, May 30th, 2023.
By the way, let me just say this right quick. So the days are going to start to get shorter here. I mean, we got about 3 weeks, and then they're going to start getting shorter. It's like we're just getting them cranked up here. Let's go. Okay.
I want to enjoy it while it's still sunny in the morning.
Well, let's still do that. Here. Just know the end's coming.
The end is nigh.
You just right rear hooked me on summer. Thanks a lot.
No, I didn't. No, that was the left rear.
Well, I pushed you into baggy. That's what got it. That's how he right hooked you there.
Oh, Brad's minding his own business, and Brad gets pulled into this. No, Brad didn't do anything wrong. He had the best seat in the house for all that. Anyway, today is Mint Julep Day.
Yum, yum, yum.
That's weird. I mean, that's Kentucky Derby territory, and that's it for me. I don't know.
On the mint julep.
I've had one. Yeah, me either. Same.
Today is National Creative Day.
You know, when the creative juices get bottled up, Eggman, you know, it's no good. That's all I'm saying.
Well, but sometimes the creative juices don't taste as good as we think they do.
Especially in the stew we're mixing up here this morning.
All right. What are you doing there? What's going on?
I have no idea what that is.
Guys, we're talking about creative juices.
serious celebration here. Mm-hmm. It's World Multiple Sclerosis Day.
Okay.
And for those of you that are affected by MS, we're thinking of you today. That's
absolutely.
That's rough.
Yeah, it is. Appreciate the work that people do around that disease, for sure.
On this day in 1431, Joan of Arc was burned at the stake in France at the age of 19.
Somebody call 911. Shoddy fire burning on the dance floor. Whoa.
I questioned myself if I should do that, but I did. I'm sorry, Joan.
How do you like your Van Arc? Medium rare?
Wow. It's like 600 years ago. I think the joke can be made.
Oh, just put her over the flame and just put her on the plate. Let's go.
Like it blew.
On this day in 1539, Hernando de Soto, the Spanish explorer, landed in Florida with 600 soldiers to search for gold.
That's gold, Jerry. Gold!
They were severely misguided. Ain't no gold in Florida.
Turn this boat around. What's this all about?
On this day in 1848, W.G. Young patented the ice cream freezer. Yes.
Thank you for that. Had some nice 80s vanilla ice cream on top of a cherry pie last night.
How heartbreaking is it, though, to open up some ice cream that maybe has been sitting in there for a minute, and you open it up, and it's freezer burnt? Like, you're just I was looking for some kind of sweet something the other night, and I was like, oh, here's some vanilla ice cream, and it's just got, like, ice crystals. Looks like Mr. Freeze was living in there. No, thank you.
Mm-mm. Chill.
Not a fan. No. On this day in 1854, the U.S. territories of Nebraska and Kansas were established.
Come on in. The water's fine. They're in the Midwest.
On this day in 1868, Memorial Day was observed widely for the first time in the United States.
Number one.
And remember, it wasn't until a few years ago, well, not a few years, but the 70s, Memorial Day was one of those floating holidays. Wherever it landed, kind of like 4th of July. Then they made it a Monday deal in the 70s.
On this day in 1879, William Vanderbilt renamed New York's Gilmore's Garden to Madison Square Garden.
Oh, we love playing in Madison Square Garden, had a lot of success there. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience playing in the Sweet 16 in New York in Madison Square Garden, and that's enough for him.
Okay. MSG, never been there. It's on my bucket list. Got
to
get there.
I would love to go there.
Me too.
Love to go there.
Billy Joel on this day, MSG.
Well, that, yes. Yeah. And I'm trying to time that up when we go to Pocono, that I could just slide over there. We're about an hour and 20 minutes from New York City, from Pocono. So, well, hour 30, depending on traffic. On this day in 1883.
Thank you.
12 people were trampled to death in New York City in a stampede when a rumor that the Brooklyn Bridge was in danger of collapsing occurred.
Was it just a rumor, or did the bridge actually collapse? That's even worse.
Brooklyn Bridge never collapsed.
That's terrible.
It's fine.
So, you checked it on your ride over to MSG to see Billy Joel? You got to go over there?
Well, I think when you go through the annals of history, the collapse of the Brooklyn Bridge would stand out and people would remember that. I don't recall ever getting a news flash
with
that.
I know the collapse of the Brooklyn Nets. I've watched that a couple of times.
But. Wow. On this day in 1896, the first automobile accident occurred in New York City.
Boy, New York is like the epicenter of the calendar today.
Well, let's take it out west. On this day in 1903, in Riverdale, New York, the first American motorcycle hill climb was held.
Okay, Riverdale.
Riveting.
On this day in 1911, Ray Haroon won the first Indianapolis 500. At the time, it was known as International 500-Mile Sweepstakes Race. Haroon's average speed was 74.59 miles per hour.
Sounds like a Borat film title. 500-Mile Sweepstakes Race, yes.
I get to kiss my wife.
Kiss the bricks.
On this day in 1921, the U.S. Navy transferred the Teapot Dome oil reserves to the Department of the Interior.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout.
Now get spewing some Texas tea. Let's go.
Texas tea. Nice. Yeah.
On this day in 1922, the Lincoln Memorial was dedicated in Washington, D.C.
Beautiful monument, for sure.
On this day, 1933, Sally Rand introduced her exotic and erotic fan dance to audiences at Chicago's Century of Progress Exposition.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout.
Look at Sally go.
Here is my handle, here is my spout.
She used to get them all steamed up back in those days with those fans.
Literally, that's what the song is. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout, tip me over and pour me up, baby.
On this day, 1967, Evel Knievel jumped 16 automobiles in a row in a motorcycle stunt at Ascot Speedway in Gardenia, California.
Oh, man. Evel Knievel. I remember they used to have the USAC midget races from there on ESPN.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
On this day, in 1971, Blue Ribbon Sports changed its name. What was it changed to?
SiriusXM Sports?
Nike.
No, Nike.
Yes.
Nike. And on this day in 2012, in the category of messing with things that don't need to be messed with, New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg announced that portion cap rule was in effect. That proposed amendment to the city health code would have required that food service establishments limit the size of sugary beverages to 16 ounces. In June of 2014, the Court of Appeals ruled that they had exceeded the scope of its regulatory authority. Leave my drinks alone. Birthdays today. Winona Judd, 59.
No one else on earth.
CeeLo Green is 47. Big L would have been 49. Mel Blanc would have been 115. In the world of NASCAR, a couple of birthdays today. Clint Bowyer and Eric Jones, salute.
Well, happy birthday, one and all, on this Tuesday, May 30th, 2023.